A very good day to all of you. As all of you know, today you will all be giving a practical test for Writer Module 1. In this practical test, you will be asked many questions and you will practically show them on your computers. Let us all understand the rules for this test. This is a practical test. You will be asked to show many options one by one. This test is for 45 minutes. For all the questions that you are asked, you will be later shown how it was to be done so that you can understand if you did it right or not. You can use this to match with your answer. If any of you find that your answer is wrong, you can see the correct answer and learn about that option. Now, all of you power on your computers and open the writer file. So, let us now begin the test. Type out the following line. Computer Shiksha gives you a better way of learning computers. Next, make this line appear 10 times on your page and show it to your teacher. Remember that all these lines should come as new lines. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. Let us now watch this video and learn the correct method of doing copy and paste. So, on your writer sheet, you have already typed the line, Computer Shiksha shows you a better way of learning computers. Let us select this line and then use the shortcut command Control C for copying it. So, we select this. Once it is selected, we use Ctrl plus C to copy it. When we do Ctrl plus C, you will not see any change happening on your writer page. However, now that you want to bring more copies of this line, you need to do paste. So, to use paste, we will use the shortcut command Ctrl plus V. Take the cursor to the new line by pressing enter, and once you press, the selection will go off, and when you do Ctrl plus V, another line appears. Again, you keep the control button pressed with your left hand and press the V key with your right hand, and like this keep on pressing to get 10 lines of the same line that you had typed. So, this is how you can use copy and paste to get these 10 lines. Do you know what is font name used for? Font name is used to change the writing style of the text. So, now you go ahead and change the writing of the first line and show it. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. Let us now watch the video and learn the correct method of changing the font name. So, to change the font name or the font writing style of the first line, we need to select the line as is being shown in the video. Now take your pointer or the cursor to the formatting bar where Times New Roman is written and click on the drop down. Now you can select any style that you like and click on that, and your first line font changes to that style. If you don't like it, you can again click on the drop down window, select another type that you like, font name, and the line will change to that. This is how you can use font name. Can you tell what is the font size used for? The font size option is used for increasing or decreasing the text size of our document. Now, all of you change the text size of the second line by selecting any size between 16 and 20. Show it to your teacher when this is done. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. This video will help us understand how we can change the size of our writing or the font size. To change the font size of the second line, you need to first select the second line on your writer page. So let's select the second line as is being shown in the video. And after you have selected the line, take your pointer to the formatting bar where the font size is written 18 and click on the drop down. Once you click here, you see many numbers. So if you choose the larger numbers, your font size will increase, or if you choose the smaller numbers, the font size of the writing will decrease. So as is being shown in the video, we are choosing 20, which is a larger font size, and as soon as we select that, you notice that our font size of the second line appears bigger. Secondly, we can change it to the lower ones also, like 16. Can you tell why bold is used? Bold is used to make your text appear thicker and darker. Now, all of you make the third line bold and also tell what is the shortcut command for bold. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. Let us now watch this video and learn the correct method of making our text bold. So to make the third line bold, first you have to select the third line, and you can do bold in two ways: the shortcut command Ctrl plus B, or by going to the format bar and selecting the B button. As is being shown in the video, you can take your pointer to the format bar and click on the bold option, which is B here. Click on that and you will see that your writing changes to thicker and darker, or it becomes bold. This is how you use bold. You can also do it by Ctrl plus B, which is the shortcut. Can you tell why is italics used? Italics option is used to make your writing appear tilted. Now go ahead and make the fourth line appear in italics. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. Let us now see in the video how we can make our selected text into italics or into tilted letters. To make the fourth line italics, let us first select the fourth line. After selecting the line, take your cursor to the formatting bar where I is written, which is for italics. You can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus I. When you click here, your text becomes tilted, or we can say the text becomes in italics. So this is how you will convert your text into italics. Can you tell why is underline used? The underline option is used to get a line to appear below the text that you want to highlight. Now, show the fifth line underlined. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. Let us now watch the video and learn the correct method to do underlining. You can do underline either through the shortcut command Ctrl plus U or by clicking on the U option in the formatting bar. For this, you first need to select the fifth line which you want to underline. So, as is being shown in the video, we are selecting the fifth line. Then we take our pointer to the U option and click on that with the left button of our mouse or touchpad. And you will notice that the line, the text that you had selected, gets underlined. Can you tell why alignment is used? Also, tell alignment is of how many types? The alignment option helps us to set our text lines properly on the writer page. Alignment is of four types: left, right, center, and justify. Now, show the sixth line as center aligned. Next, right align the seventh line and show to your teacher. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer, and in case your answer was wrong, correct the same. This video will show us how we can do alignment on our text. For doing alignment, you may or may not select the line. So, for doing alignment, you have to keep your cursor or the pointer in the beginning of the line, as is being shown in the video, and then you bring the pointer to the format bar center alignment option and click with the left button of your mouse or touchpad, and you will notice that the line becomes centrally aligned. Now for the next line, you want to do alignment, so keep the cursor in the beginning of the line and bring the pointer to the format bar right alignment option. And when you click there, you will notice your line gets right aligned. Can you tell why we use font color? We use font color to make our text appear in the color of our choice. Go ahead and show the change in font color on the eighth line. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. This video shows us how we can change the font color of our selected text. So to change the color of the font or the color of the writing, we first have to select our line. So we are now selecting the line as is being shown in the video, and we take our pointer or the cursor to the formatting bar where A is written. Next to A, you will find a small drop down arrow. Click on that with your left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and a box opens where many colors are there. You have to select the your choice of color, and when you click on that, you will notice that your writing, the text gets changed to the color of your choice. So this is how you can change the font color. Can you tell why we use highlighting color? The option highlighting color is used to change the color of the background of the text that we select. Using this, you can change the background color of your text or the paragraph till the place you have typed the text. Next, highlight the ninth line and show the same. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. This video shows us how we can use highlighting of the text. Highlighting helps us to change the color of the background of our text. So for this, we first select our line as is being shown in the video, and then take our pointer or the cursor to the AB option in the formatting bar and click on the drop down. When we click there, you see many colors and you can choose the one which you like and select that by left clicking on your mouse or touchpad, and you will notice that the text that you had selected gets highlighted in that color. Can you tell what is background color option used for? Using background color, you can change the color of the background of your line or paragraph or full page. Now, show the changed background color for the 10th line. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer and make corrections. Let us see how we can change the background color of a selected line. For this, we need to first select the line. As is being shown in the video, we select the line and then we have to take the pointer or the cursor to the formatting bar where the background color option is there and click. Many colors will appear in the box and you need to choose the color that you want as the background of your text. So once you click on that color, you will notice that the background color of the selected line changes. This is how you change the background color. Now, all of you save your file on the desktop. You can save your file with your name and also write practical test. For example, computer shiksha practical test. Come, let us now watch the video and know the correct answer. Let us now watch this video to learn the correct method to save our file. So to save the file, you first need to take your pointer or the cursor to the file menu in the menu bar and click on that. Select the save option with the left button of the mouse or the cursor. Now, you can notice there is an address bar and you can save your file in many locations like in downloads or in documents or even on the computer's C drive or D drive. Right now you have to save in desktop, so you will select desktop and then come to the line where it says file name. Here type the file name, like with your name you can type practical test, or in our case we are typing computer shiksha practical test. As is being shown in the video, we type the file name that we want to save the file with. Then we press the save button, we click on that. Your file gets saved, and to check if the file has been saved properly, you can see in the title bar, as is being shown here, the name computer shiksha practical test is appearing. Next, convert this file to PDF format and save it on the desktop with your name. Now watch the video for the correct method and convert your file into PDF. Let us once again see with this video how we can convert our file to PDF. To convert the file to PDF, bring your cursor or pointer to the file menu in the menu bar and click on that. A box opens and you have to look for the export as PDF option. Click on the export as PDF option to select that, and another box opens. You have to make no changes in any of the options. Just take the cursor to the export option and click on that. Another box opens and you can decide where you want to locate your file or store it, and also change the file name. Give any file name and press the save button. We have stored it on desktop. To see if this file has been saved as PDF on the desktop, we minimize the writer file, and on the desktop, we will now see where our file is, and it is here. So we, to open this, we have to do a double click on this icon of the PDF file. So when we do a double click on this icon, our file opens. Now, if you notice, if you put the cursor or in this text and try to type anything, you cannot type anything on the PDF file. So this is how you can save your PDF file. We will end today's class now. Remember that your file should be saved on your desktop in both writer and PDF format. In the next class, you will all be appearing for a written test. The questions will be of multiple choice type, which will have 4 possible answers for each question, and you need to tick on the right answer. After the written test, the Writer 2 module will start, in which you will learn more about Writer. Thank you.